Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back on Nike's Racing. Marco speaking from Italy, and welcome back also on my YouTube channel, where I try to bring to your screens, I hope, something not seen previously, or at least not seen massively in the recent period. So what are you going to watch today, if you like? Basically, I am playing two main themes. The first one is Grand Prix Manager 2, the game you see with this splash screen currently, that came out in 1996, still from Microprose, the same producer of the Grand Prix series. And it was the second chapter of a tentative made some years before, maybe also some months before, that maybe was not so successful, at least in Italy where I live and when I did grow up. This one was absolutely a sort of blockbuster, if you like. I mean, not from a pure sales point of view, but for the community of young virtual racers, very keen to play hours and hours of racing with Grand Prix 2, with IndyCar Racing 2. This was mainly the first, let's say, serious manager-themed game regarding Formula 1. And back then was also not linked to internet, or at least in Italy, the mid-90s were not, let's say, ready immediately for the internet connections. And so a lot that you find nowadays on the web was not available back then, 25 years ago. I must say also that this one, despite it doesn't put you inside a race car, was anyway very exciting for two reasons. The main one was that was the first, at least easily playable by also virtual racers, virtual managers that were not, let's say, so much prepared to manage a Formula One team. The second reason was for sure the soundtrack that you are hearing and listening in the background, that was also obtainable digging inside the original CD-ROM, so you had the possibility to move those WAV files into a playlist, into whatever you liked. And nowadays, after 25 years, I must admit that together with the playlist I used to train myself doing running one day yes and one day no, this playlist, it's always anyway present on my iPod, more or less since 2007 when I've purchased my first iPod. So really lasted a lot, maybe because it is just a mix of ambient, chill out and electronic music, but in my opinion it was very well prepared, very well composed for the game itself. The other theme, the other disclaimer if you like, is that you are not going to hear the commentary of Mario Poltronieri, that in Italy has been well beloved, like Murray Walker has been in UK, for example. And this also because Mario Poltronieri, tragically we lost some years ago, was anyway a driver before becoming a journalist and for becoming a speaker for the national TV channels. And so today, unluckily, you will have my voice in English, not maybe also perfectly spoken, and sorry for this, but just in case you should purchase the original CD-ROM, you will get for sure, for what I remember, Murray Walker for the UK version and Mario Poltronieri for the Italian version. So that's another disclaimer point that was very, let's say, felt inside myself. And all of this brings then to the Cheater new playlist sub-channel, if you like, that is more an experiment than a sort of already decided continuously theme within my channel. But I think that this game and the meaning of being a cheater was perfectly fitting the idea I have behind today this video. That being said, as a general advertisement, I'm not going to play fairly this game. I'm just not doing also a tutorial. It's just a mix between cheating and trying to give you in few episodes the maximum I can transfer to you all, if you would like to maybe one day to try this game, because instructions are not really, let's say, are really well made, but they do not explain between the lines, if you like. I want to try to propose you a first taste of this game, using all the possible cheating usage of tips, tricks, etc. And also a bit of my knowledge that Race by Race will come back again, I think. That being said, we will play the long-term contract, so we will have anyway 10 years of tentatives to win the championship, both with drivers and with the team. And also we will choose the easiest level, and it is just for the purpose to arrive to a point. If you then choose a difficult level, you basically can more or less get the same winning results just on a longer period. But for the purpose of this video, I'm going really to let's say avoid any fair playing attitude. I will be just a cheater like hell. So from the main menu, as said, the game came out in 1996, so we have the first year for Schumacher driving the Ferrari, and Villeneuve, Jacques, and Damon Hill battling with the Williams Renault for the championship. So we can go on, we choose the long term contract, we choose the rookie level, we start with this, and because the game proposes you to have the management of Benetton, Williams and Ferrari at rookie level, let's say that choosing one of these three top teams doesn't allow you to, let's say, have proper management of every aspect, especially from a sponsor point of view, because if you choose Benetton, Williams or Ferrari, you already have sponsors, or anyway you already have the interest of the best sponsors available for the Formula One environment we are proposing. So at the end we start with this team, the Tsunami team, that is a fake one, like Cassini. The only real back in 1996 were from Forti Corse to Minardi, Footwork, etc., going up to Benetton, that was the winner the previous season of both drivers and constructor championships. That being said, we choose Tsunami. We go to another screen where we can change something, and here the only suggestion I have is for your team at least to get a name that you like, and if you don't mind I would like to call it as it is. No problem to keep the manager name as it is. Call me Tyron, even if my name is Marco, no problem. We are not going to change the engine, even if we could at this stage, choosing also the best engine available, or we can edit afterwards, before the first race of the season, this type of parameter. So we stay with Ilmor. As you can see, we are the player, and currently, apart from Cassini, all the other teams are played by computer. So I would suggest also to turn Cassini as driven by the computer. If you like, and if this is your will, on the web you can find a lot of ads-on regarding correct color shapes and season and sponsorship, etc., for all the cars. And also you can bring back different seasons, so you really can play, I don't remember from which year to up to when, maybe also almost the 2020 season is under preparation or is prepared, I don't know, but I've seen a community really well prepared to offer you whatever you like. So just go on the web, on Google, and if you try GPM to add on, you can find really another world. That being said, we go on this way. So with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 12, 13 teams, and so 26 drivers, and we go on this way. If we play OK, we go to another let's say customization windows before accessing the real game, and it's here when I would suggest to have a look to your team, discover that, for example, this Giovanni Vaille from Italy is quite has a strong character, but is not a good driver. As a comparison, if you get Michael Schumacher, you can see basically he is the best of the field. The same can be said, I don't know, almost for Hakkinen, or Damon Hill, etc. Anyway, the only editing, cheating, bad like hell attitude I will have today is to transform my Giovanni Vail into a monster better than Schumacher, so giving him 5 stars everywhere. And it will be important when, let's say, you will have to make a comparison between car setup and, let's say, almost a race strategy. And if you don't mind, it will become Ikey's Racing 1. We bring down the age to 18, and it's not a driver for hire, so basically you pay him to drive. So let's do this first thing. Then we go to the second driver, that is Ty Chatirel. If you don't mind, this not really Italian name becomes Ikey's Racing 2. He is almost, he is also 18 years old, is not a driver for hire, and it will become a monster like the first driver. Okay, let's go also to the tester, that is this Roger Elmer, if he is really with a French nationality. If you don't mind, it becomes an Italian driver too. It goes down to 18 years old and becomes a monster like the other two. We are now approaching a season with the best driver combination possibly allowed by this game. And sorry, I would like to call it Ikey's Racing 3. Just to give a sort of chronological importance between the first driver, the second, and the tester, but believe me, they are absolutely all the same. There's no difference at all. That being said, we go also to the chief designers, because when you start with a rookie challenge, so at the basic level available, what you have is also very often a good team of main manager and main directors, both from chief designer, mechanic chief, and blah blah blah. And what you can do is increase at the maximum their stars. You can also avoid to touch the other, just increase at the maximum your people. Here we have the chief engineers, again 5 stars, the chief mechanic 5 stars, commercial manager 5 stars. Okay, so we should be really, I hope I've pushed okay, perfect. We are not going to touch the 1996 race calendar, that is the original one. From a team point of view, we are not going to touch anything. Also from a winning point of view, we keep what was back in 1996. So the first 6 drivers score points, like in the previous years. The engine, this is the other part I would like to edit. So because we are racing with the Ilmor, that as you can see is the only engine on the grid to have 2 stars, you can bring up to 5 stars also this one, at least yours. You can also be massively a cheater and bring, for example, a Renault to half a star, etc. But I would like to suggest to keep the rest as it is, just to have a proper historic representation. And I don't think we have anything else to do. We can also avoid to save settings, no problem. And maybe we can choose, I don't know, a different logo, because we don't call the team anymore Tsunami. I don't see anything. Okay, maybe we can choose this one with the R and the similar I before the R. If you like, if you are good on editing games, you can import also your own logo and go on this way. Okay, it's all prepared. This first episode will be just, let's say, the setup from the second episode onwards. I'm going to play races, just to give you a sort of pre-schedule of what I'm going to present you. So if you are not interested on races, you can just watch this episode. If you are interested more in races, you can skip this first episode and go on. So we can go on with the logo, with the Ilmor, blah, 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 and push OK. Now, final OK. We can avoid to save settings, or maybe we save it. Yes, I save it also to talk you about one thing. Because this game was originally projected to be played under Microsoft DOS or Windows 95, you can choose a maximum name for saving things of 8 letters. So I would say that maybe IKR setup is already at the limit of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 letters, like was originally thought for files coming from Microsoft DOS environment. Okay, we have saved everything. We can put our OK clicked, and now we are in the main view. The first thing I would like to specify is that with the rookie level, you start with $20 million. That is a nice amount. You can manage, let's say, easily a winning team already. For a backmarker team like this one, maybe they are not enough. And so the first thing would be to increase this amount of money. Also because you are new to the 1996 season, you are not known, you are not a winning team, you are a rookie team. And if you go to see what is the sponsorship interest, you will have that the best sponsor are not interested in you. And sometimes you start the season at least with one sponsor, not really full of wealth, if you like. So could be also immediately a sort of precise attitude to say, to increase money, I look for sponsorship. Yes and no, because then you basically block the space on your car with a low level sponsor. So my first suggestion would be, when you arrive at this stage, start to save the game. Absolutely, there will be also a test, IKR 1996, yes. And the first thing would be to basically have an incredible amount of money, so you don't have to go to a bank, you don't have to go or to risk your bankruptcy, etc. So when you are here, just click in the center of the screen, use the caps lock, and with capital letters write I am a cheater. Here we are. Thanks to this, you can activate the cheat mode. You can increase your money up to 2,140,000 dollars. So really no problem at all. We do it once at the beginning of the season that we don't touch anymore. Okay, yes, because after 2,145,000 dollars, you get the minus 2 billions. So just leave as it is. This is the first thing to do. And as you can see here, we have money. We start to save. Okay. The other thing is that during the 10 years long-term contract you have as a race director of this team, you will face very often the fact that, for example, rules will change. So you start with the 96 figure, so no limit for developing anything internal, anything external. But from an electronic point of view, you will not have active suspension, traction control, etc. And generally speaking, you have to develop them year by year. So sometimes rules change and you are not ready, especially if you have a small team of engineers, etc. So the first thing I would do is talk about what is your personal help from the people that works with you. And for example, as you can see, you have contact for this year, both from designers, engineers, mechanic, commercial manager, engine supplier, and also the same for drivers. So the first thing to make more stable your team would be to extend all these contracts. Also because, if you remember, we have now 5-star into everything. Our, let's say, technicians are 5-stars, our drivers are 5-stars. So the first thing would be to go to the personal, start with the chief designer, and first of all, offer him at least 30 people available for the design, and offering him a new deal that, if you like or if you don't like, must be increased by the original figure. So if he's earning this amount, I would suggest increase a bit, and also go as an average to 3 years contract, add a zero to the bonuses, and then offer the deal. And as you can see, generally speaking, they accept. I do not remember if at the highest level of difficulties they are not so keen to continue to work with you, but at least at the rookie stage it's easier to get a contract. Why I'm doing this? Because even if we cheat, it's always important to have a strong, let's say, team of people behind during also the season. And so I always try to, let's say, be stable at least for a 3 years period. Okay, 1-0 added, offer a deal, he accepts. Let's go also to the mechanic. Here I would say 30 people, almost 40 is better. You have two cars, remember, to manage. And also here, okay, perfect. Let's see what we are missing. The commercial manager absolutely must have a lot of people, and we have to hire him also for the next 3 years. Okay, let's go to, okay, let's also do the same for drivers. So we have to extend the contract of this guy that is earning $10,000 per year, really not a huge amount. And if he wins a race, okay, let's go to extend a different deal. Yes, we have extended to 48 races. Perfect. We do the same with the number two, so we double the values almost. And let's go to negotiate also with the third driver. This is not science, I mean, it's just okay. Now the ridiculous thing is that the driver number two now gets, if he wins races, gets the double of bonuses of the first driver, but who cares, he gets less than championship bonus. I mean, they are really numbers put like they are. We have an amount of money more than enough to play 10 seasons. Anyway, that being said, we have extended everything we could. We should not have injured drivers, perfect. And we still have to play with contracts. So we will see after five, six races how the Ilmor engine will perform. But we need anyway to check our contract. So we start with the best quality tires supplier for 1 year, 16 races. Let's go to see the spare parts. We work with Elite, 5 stars. Okay, fuel provided by Mack, and works especially well with Ilmor, so we are lucky. 1 year contract. And also security, we are working with A1 security for this season. Can happen that because there are many teams involved in the same security supplier, sometimes can happen that you lose some technology here and there. It's not a bug, it is a precise choice of the programmers to move you as much as possible, as soon as possible, to a strong company supplying security but with less clients. So for example, Silva, if should earn 1 star more for the next season, could be a choice to think about. Okay, from a contract point of view, we are okay. From a design point of view, this is the first part of what you get normally. So you have four lines shelves that has just two or three parts developed. If you cheat, you get all of them, and this works for basically any possible type of internal system or external system. So what I would do is go again here, click in the center, write I am a cheat, and go to develop all parts, go to make sponsors like me. And another thing is that from a facility point of view, you have this beautiful green ground empty, and you just have the headquarters. So this is not, let's say, the best possible scenario, even if we are going to develop all the parts. So for example, the internals now are completely full of possibility for any possible aspect, and the same can be said for externals. You don't have just a single shelf, but you have all the possibilities developed, and it's more than good. So because we don't have to produce this stuff, it's also true that we have to design a new car. And to design a new car for the next season is something you have to put in place anyway at the start of a new season. So you need a CAD, a computer aided design, but also you have to manufacture what you have designed. So you need a computer aided manufacturing, etc, 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 because you don't have anything of this. And it will cost around 3, 4, 5 to 6 million. I would suggest to go here, click again at the center of the screen, write I am a cheat, bring back this cheating window pop up, and build all facilities. We already developed all parts. We can avoid to unban all parts, but just in case, what is currently as driver 8 flagged by a black flag can become available, I don't know, immediately after 2 races. So if you have it ready, the better. So you go back here, click in the center, I am a cheat, and after you develop next part, I don't remember if you have to click it in a sort of obsessive compulsive way, improve driver 8, okay, design driver 8, okay. We're still missing 2 levels, so again, I am a cheat. Let's click in obsessive way everything. You can hear the sound of the clicks. Okay, let's go back. So, internals, all developed. Externals, maybe this one was the only one. Okay, all developed like before. We should finally have, at level number 10, everything available. So it's just a matter of time to, let's say, have them allowed by the FIA and then used immediately. From a manufacturing point of view, you don't have to produce anything because you already have internal and external parts, so we are okay. The only thing we could do is the new car chassis development will, let's say, put in a angle what you could do with research and development during the season, because we have cheated like hell. And so my suggestion would be to follow the instructions of the game for what it is, and avoid to have the new car for the next season ready mid-season in this current year, or too late in the season. So I would suggest to start between a 60% on design of the new car and 40% on research and development that is not used because we have cheated, to have all the active suspensions, traction control, etc. And that being said, I think it's a nice setup to start the season. Also, the last thing, from a sponsorship point of view, even if you have cheated with me making a sponsor like me, as you can see, you don't have already all the best sponsors easily on board with you. You just get the cheapest one. So keep as they are, no problem. If you start to win and make results, they will come to you. And also keep, let's say, free your car from sponsorship, because for example, if I should accept $337,000 for this year 16 races, if I have the opportunity to get during the season a better sponsor, I have to wait until the end of the season, and I will earn, if you do the calculation, less than $25,000 per race. So not really a lot. I would suggest at the beginning, just be careful on this. Don't sell the best part, don't sell the minor parts, just keep everything blank. But anyway, ask your office to spend with the best sponsorships at least 15% of time, and keep anyway a bit of time free, a 10% free for your people working at the marketing side of the team. The other thing is to go to the merchandise, and because you are not a winning team, as you can see, some lines are not allowed, but what is allowed, I would suggest produce it, and always come here after each race to verify, to continue to produce merchandising, because for example this calendar, this poster has 5 races, a contract for 5 races, like the calendar for 4, etc. And so, let's say, if you come back here after each race, you get the correct, always available merchandise following you race by race. Okay, we can give a save. We can read the news. Well, nothing special to be honest so far. From a finance point of view, you will see that we have already spent a bit in construction. I don't remember what we have built up, but who cares? And we can go on. The second part of this video will be just about testing, because before the start of the season you have any way to test your car, and to test your car you have to also test the best part you can get to be really quick. Also because currently we are 57 kilograms heavier than the minimum allowed by the rules. So even if you already have some parts mounted, for example the track spar is the fourth on out of 16 possible solutions for front suspension. So I would use this new part and fit the car with the best. It does cost you a bit, yes, no worries. You go then to the second car and do the same. You go to the third car and do the same. Okay. And then you can do the same for externals and also the car number 3. Okay, and as you can see, we have moved from 650, almost 660 kilograms to 595. That is good. So engineers and mechanics have 5 kilograms to pay, to use, sorry, as a ballast to better balance the car. But before doing it during race day, I would say let's go to make a test. We have chosen to be a British team, an Italian team, but based in Great Britain. So let's go here. Also because if we choose another track, for example in Germany or Portugal, you can see that the price is $100,000. If you choose your home soil is $8,000, so not bad. So we accept it. We load the car setup that I think I had already prepared somewhere yesterday. Yes, Silverstone dry, perfect. You can copy plans to all the cars and you can start. Even if the driver already says something, just make him run the car for a couple of laps. But when I say a couple of laps, I suggest to always choose on test the car improvement, always do 100 laps and start the test and see what happens. And as the first driver says, we need more testing. More testing, okay. Just check the wings settings, because as you can see, it's all perfect apart from the wing settings and the brake balance. The brake balance is a bug. So just consider that sometimes you are required to move the brake balance to the front, but it's like a bug that continues to say to you the brake balance is too near to the rear. You bring it front, bring it front, bring it front, until the car spins and you cannot test or race anymore. So just avoid this basically. Let's go to the wings, and he was saying that was too high, so we can go down. You can go down by 2 ticks every time and copy plans to all the cars and redo the test again. As you can see, after 100 laps already did before, you start to wear out parts of the car, and so it didn't make 100 laps, just 73, and will continue to decrease and go down. But the main thing is that we have reduced by 1 second the previous lap time. We need more testing and we are going to do it. And when the driver says the chassis feels good, I can push harder, if you were in a race day, you could give instruction to the driver to push really harder. Anyway, let's start again the test. And this is another phrase that comes up after 2 or 3 or 4 tentatives, when you basically have the changing mood, let's say, of the driver, that from we need more testing says the results look good. It does mean he has arrived also from a timing point of view to the best he can do today. So we can switch driver, go to the second one, still car improvements, just checking, sorry, what was saying, the front wing was too high, so we can reduce by 1, copy plans to all, go back to the second driver, start the test, car improvement, 100 laps. Result looks good, but he is not at the same level of the driver number 1, so Let's test again. Come on, let's test again. No. Okay, we are there. 121.7. Perfect. Just check the car setup. The front wing is too high. Okay, we can go down to another tick. Less time to date, blah, blah, blah. Front wing is too high, so we go down again. Copy plans to all. And now we move to the driver number 3 to make him also his test date. It's important if you have 3 drivers to make also the reserve driver run at least during tests. Because instead he becomes full of finishes the passions and tries to go away. Remember that now we have 3 drivers, 5 stars everywhere, so you have to keep your tester as much as possible with you. He would be an asset to favor your contenders, basically. Let's see. Okay, setting perfect, so we can save the setup as a Silverstone dry, copy plans to all the cars, and finish with another session, or maybe 2, also the tester. 121.5, best time today. Again, start test. Okay, very strange, he says 2 times the result looks good, but we need more testing. I would say, go to car performances now. Test, performances hasn't changed. Test again, okay. So we switch driver, and we ask the first driver to do a car performance test as a comparison. And now finally, you have just 12 sessions to do with your drivers. Best lap time scored by the driver number 1. No, sorry, the tester is quicker than the driver number 1. Who knows why? They are all equal, same age, same stars. And the second driver is still half a second far. We will see during the season if the driver number 2 is too far from the 1. We will bring on board the driver number 3 that looks to be fast as the first driver. Okay, we can conclude the test. The reports are there. And let's go back to the main menu. Okay, we save it. Okay, back to the main screen. We can save the game. And as you can see, we have spent almost 2 million and half dollars in testing parts, etc. Before going to the first race of the season, you should follow that after a test, internals and external parts of each car are obviously worn out, and if you wait the race day, you may risk to not have enough parts to fit your car. So the advice is, starting from car number 1, again fit with best parts, yes, that are also the parts tested when we have been in testing day at Silverstone. And that makes a difference, because another suggestion would be never race a racing weekend with parts you have not tested. So the car is perfectly in shape for driver 1, driver 2, driver 3. Let's check easily and immediately also the internal part, and I could bet that after the race we will be more or less around the mid wearing part of each single component. When we will be back in the office after the first race will be again time to check this particular, let's say, activity that you have to do every time you come back from a race day. Okay, that being said, we should have everything in place. The video, I suppose, is around 30 minutes or something more, so I save the game. This first episode ends here, and I would like to give you the appointment to the next one, when we will race. Let me see the calendar. Where is it? I don't remember where is it. Diary, maybe this one. Yes, we'll be in Melbourne. And now, I don't know, but maybe we will be successful between 30 to 45 minutes to race 3 races in a row. Anyway, we will discover it, and I will try to condense many races into just one single episode. So that's it for the moment. Thank you for watching so far. I give you the appointment, as I said, to the episode number 2, where we will race the Melbourne Grand Prix, the Brazilian Grand Prix, the Australian, the Brazilian, and the Argentine Grand Prix. But we will check step by step how much time it will require. So thank you again, and see you very soon. As always, if you don't know what to do, stay home, stay safe, stay racing. Bye.